الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله الحمد الحق الحمد لله المحيي المميت الحمد لله المبدئ المعين الأول الآخر الظاهر الباطن الذي ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونسترشده ونستعطيه ونعوذ به سبحانه من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا نظير له ولا مثيل له ولا كفء له إقرارا بربوبيته وإغراما بمن جحد به وكفر وأشهد أن محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من بين خلقه وخليله الذي بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به كل أمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك سيدا للخلق والبشر صلوات ربي وسلامه عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وصحبك الطيبين الطائعين الطاهرين وعلى من تبعهم واقتفى آثارهم وعلينا معهم أجمعين إلى يوم الدين اللهم آمين الله سبحانه وتعالى says واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون An advice that I pass to myself and I pass to my brothers and sisters To fear a day that you will all return to Allah and each and every nafs will be rewarded accordingly and no one will be treated unjustly. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless these faces before you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you the effort you exalted to show up in His house today and to build His masjid. May Allah gather us all and our children and our offsprings and make best of them all together, inshallah, in Jannat al-Na'im. Ibad Allah, it's this time of the year again. It's the end, towards the end of December. And I still remember myself standing here in this holy mosque, in this very same spot, addressing my beloved brothers and sisters, looking at these beautiful faces about a year ago, around the same time. And I surely done that the year before. Years are creeping on us rather rapidly, taking along with them parts of our lives. And parts of us, slowly but surely, transforming our children into teenagers and our adults into elderly and old, flaming this brown and black and blonde hair into white and bending that straight beautiful back into an awkward, bended curve and bows. It sure has made, these years passing have made our memories rather short. And it made our knees and our bones rather weak. It made, my dear brothers and sisters, the healthy sick, and it turned the elderly into more of a diseased and terminated state. May Allah bless all of those who left us.
Amen.
Allahumma ameen. All to emphasize on one very true fact that we all are aware of, that nothing will remain on the surface of this earth except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing. Allah told us in Surah Al-Qasas, كل شيء هالك إلا وجهه. Everything will perish except for his honorable face. And in Surah Ar-Rahman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كل من عليها فان. Each and everything that is on earth will perish. وَيَبْقَى وَجْهُ رَبِّكَ ذُو الْجَلَالِ وَالْإِكْرَامِ. And will remain the face of thy Lord with majesty and all bounty and honor. All brothers and sisters in cycles, it is by the blessing of Allah, by the mercy of Allah, that He made things around us go in cycles. A year come, a year after a year, and a month after a month, and a week after a week, and a minute after a minute, a season after a season, all in cycles. A day comes, a day leaves. A night comes, a night leaves. A star shows up, and a star leaves. A plant grows, and a plant dies and leaves. Water comes, and water leaves. People come, and people leaves, all in cycles. So we may reflect to the fact that no one will be in it forever. So we may reflect to the fact that everything that comes must leave, and everything that has a start must end. وَيَبْقَى وَجْهُ رَبِّكَ ذُو الْجَلَالِ وَالْإِكْرَامِ. And the face of your Lord will remain with all honor and all majesty, because He does not start. Thus He does not leave, and He does not come. Yes, He does not leave, He does not start, He does not end. Cycles, so we may reflect on this phenomenon that we see by the blessing of Allah, to see it on a daily basis. In Surah Al-Furqan, Allah tells us, وَهُوَ الَّذِي. It is He who جَعَلَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ خِلْفَةً. Made nights and days to succeed one another. Made the night and day succeed one another. لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يَذَّكَّرَ. For he who wants to reflect and remember. وَمَنْ أَرَادَ شُكُورًا. And he wanted to demonstrate thankfulness. All cycles, my dear brothers and sisters. So we may reflect. So we may say that these sky cycles are coming to an end. Each cycle is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Each one of these cycles is in the hands of Allah. No one knows where this cycle will end. But sure enough, the way they're going, rest assured that this cycle will end soon. As Abu Darda, a Sahabi, once said, O the son of Adam, hit the ground with your foot, for soon it will turn into your grave. O the son of Adam, you are not but bunch of days. Every time you use a day, you lose a day. Oh, the son of Adam, from the moment you came to this life, you have been in a state of destruction of your age. until your cycle will end. Strange, wallahi, strange indeed, to see individuals preparing a week and two and three and a month before the end of the year so they can celebrate the end of the last year and the coming of the new year. Celebration of what? Had they only known that a part of their life is gone, a part of that span of their age is gone, and they're celebrating the coming of their fate. It should rather be maybe a weep. It should be a moment of sadness, a moment of fear, a moment of reflection. The Beloved of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in a very, very famous hadith that you all know and you all have heard. He said, اغتنم خمسا قبل خمس. اغتنم, take advantage of five before five. Shabab, your youth, قبل هرم, before your old age. وصحتك, your health, قبل سقمك, before your sickness. وغناك, your wealth, قبل فقرك, before your poverty. Take advantage. وفراغك, and your spare time, قبل شغلك, before you get busy. وحياتك, قبل موتك, and your life before your death. Take advantage of five before five. Be wise. Be smart. Reflect on things that are around you. Everything around you tells you that this cycle is about to end. Do not fall for the slopes and the temptations of this dunya. Do not. Google up all the universes, all the planets, and see how Earth is beautiful. It's green and blue and white. Gorgeous. And then read in Surah Al-Kahf. وَلَقَدْ زَيَّنَّا السَّمَاءَ الدُّنْيَا. Allah says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّا جَعَلْنَا مَا عَلَى الْأَرْضِ زِينَةً لَهَا. We have made that which on earth a decoration. لِنَبْلُوَهُمْ أَيُّهُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. So we may test them, prove to them which of them is better and which of them is closer to Allah. Which of them reflects Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And his beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in many, many hadiths and many ayats that this dunya is worth nothing. 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 As the Prophet Muhammad used to say, كُنْ فِي الدُّنْيَا كَأَنَّكَ غَرِيبٌ أَوْ عَابِرِ سَبِيلٌ. Live in this dunya like a stranger or a passing by traveler. Live. Do not make this dunya your objective. We are not made for this dunya, you are not. So do not fall into its slopes. As Allah says in Surah Al-Ankabut, وَمَا هَذِي الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا لَعِبٌ وَلَهُ. That this hayat al-dunya is nothing but little fun and little amusements. وَإِنَّ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ وَإِنَّ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ. And that place in the hereafter, لَهِيَ الْحَيَوَانِ. It is the true life. It is the true life. لَوْ كَانُوا لَيَعْلَمُونَ. Only if they know. Only if they use what's around them to reflect and know what's awaiting for them. وَإِنَّ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةَ لَهِيَ الْحَيَوَانِ. The beloved of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once told his ashab, لَوْ كَانَتْ هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا, if this dunya was تُسَاوِي عِنْدَ اللَّهِ جَنَاحَ بَعُوضَةَ, it was worth to Allah the wing of a mosquito, مَا سَقَى الْكَافِرَ مِنْهَا شَرْبَةً, he would have not given the disbeliever in this dunya a sip of water. But because it's worthless, this dunya is worthless to Allah, he gives the disbelievers and gives them more and more and more, and let them fall in it deeper and deeper and celebrate more and more. And suddenly, they face the truth. Suddenly, we'll see themselves standing before the Haqq. Suddenly they will realize that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not talking from himself, but it was a wahi from Allah. La ilaha illallah. On the day of judgment, my dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring the dunya, will bring it in the shape of an old, saggy, wrinkled, ajouz lady with worn teeth, ugly, that no one can look at. And he will present it. He will present it to all the creation. And he says, this is what you used to compete in the dunya for. This is what you have made your main focus in this dunya. This is what you fought for and hated each other for in the dunya. Then Allah will order for this old lady to be thrown in the hellfire. It will say, oh my Lord, where are those who loved me? Where are those who strived for me? And they will be ordered to be thrown along with that old lady, which is the dunya. Ya ibad Allah, in the last khutbah, we spoke about how wishes are deceiving. And we said to be hopeful and to work hard and to be focused and to remember that you are a believer. And in this khutbah, I remind myself and my brothers, do not rely on tomorrow. If you have a sapling in your hand and Qiyamah is about to go, plant it. Don't say, I will. Do what you can, because you don't know. You don't know at what phase of the cycle you are. You don't know where that cycle is going to end. We don't know who's going to walk out of this door. If someone in this place can affirm that he will go out of this door at this moment, let me know. We don't know. Make the akhirah your focus. Make the pleasure of Allah your focus and act upon it. And when you forget, remind yourself again and again and again. Allahumma la taj'al ad-dunya akbar hammina. Oh Allah, don't make this dunya our main focus. وَلَا مَبْلَغَ عِلْمِنَا. Oh Allah, don't make the knowledge of this dunya the level which we seek, but grant us the knowledge of the Akhirah. And make the Akhirah our place of stay. Make the Akhirah the place of our children to stay. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَيَا فَوْزَ الْمُسْتَغْفِرِينَ. أَسْتَغْفِرُ. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. It is by the mercy and the guidance of Allah that we say what we say and we comprehend what we comprehend and we do what we do. It is all in the hands of Allah, and we have nothing and we have no fadl in anything that we do. All the praises and all the fadl is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibadallah, there is this wisdom that says, لَوْ دَامَتْ لِغَيْرِكْ لَمَا وَصَلَتْ إِلَيْهِ. If it had lasted to umams, to nations before us, it would have never ever had reached to us. It would have never ever have come to us. How many savings accounts, how many were spent by others, and how many luxury villas and mansions were enjoyed by others, and how many goodies that we thought we're going to use ended up being used by others. Don't be deceived. A key surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Alhaakum at-takathur. Alhaakum at-takathur. Do not be deceived. Do not be deceived by making more in this dunya. Do not lose focus by making more in this dunya. Hatta zurtumul maqabir. Until you have visited and saw and experienced the graves. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who hear the saying and follow the best of it. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ هَدَاهُمُ اللَّهُ. Those are the ones with guidance. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ. And those are the ones with true minds. اللهم لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك ولعظيم سلطانك. اللهم لك الحمد حتى ترضى ولك الحمد ما رضيت ولك الحمد بعد الرضا ولك الحمد دائما أبدا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك وصفيك وخليلك وحبيبك محمد في الأولين وفي الآخرين وفي الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين وفي كل وقت وحين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا، ولا تجعل واجعل الجنة هي دارنا، ولا تجعل النار مآلنا يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم اهدنا لأحسن الأقوال والأفعال والأخلاق، لا يهدي لأحسنها إلا أنت. استر عوراتنا وآمن روعاتنا، واحفظنا من بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعن أيماننا وعن شمائلنا ومن فوق رؤوسنا. نعوذ بك يا ربنا من زوال نعمتك وتحول عافيتك وفجاءة نقمتك وجميع سخطك. اللهم استر عوراتنا يا أكرم الأكرمين، وارحمنا وارحم آبائنا وأمهاتنا كما ربنا صغارا. اللهم ارحمنا وارحم آبائنا وأمهاتنا كما ربنا صغارا. اللهم فرج عن هذه الأمة ما نزل بها من كرب عظيم. اللهم انظر إلى هذه الأمة بعين الرحمة والرأفة والعون، كلها داعما ومؤيدا وناصرا، وانصرها نصرا عزيزا مؤزرا. يا من لا يشغله سمع عن سمع، ولا تغلطه كثرة المسائل، ولا يتبرم بإلحاح عباده الملحين عليه. يا رحمن يا رحيم، أذقنا برد رحمتك وكرم استجابتك. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأقم الصلاة.